what is the procedure to stay to get an unconnected status with your known circuit, for example your colleagues as well as your peer group, in a rather polite and genuine manner? Because throughout our lives we are being told that your parents are bringing up, then you have a responsibility to take to look after themselves in the world. And if somebody tries to go and live in his or her way, then they tell that ye monk banna chah raha hai, paharon pe chal jaye, akele tu aise reh nahi sakta.
It does not matter what the other is saying. The other may say that you are looking like a monk, you better become more worldly. Or the other may say that son, you have wrongly chosen marketing as your area, better get into finance. Most of the CEOs come from finance background. The other may say anything, but that cannot be more than a piece of information to you. Let that not become your decision. Getting information from others is alright. Getting decision from others is an insult to your intelligence. More often than not, we do not seek information, we seek decisions from others. Let that not happen. By all means, listen to others. Information can only come from outside, but let that not become an influence. There is a difference between information and influence. Be informed, but do not be influenced.
So that's what I was asking, if a person is living completely alone, without his parents.
Aloneness does not mean living without parents. Here with you, in this audience, I'm still alone. You are confusing aloneness with physical solitude. Aloneness does not mean being physically isolated. Aloneness means being complete in yourself. Aloneness means not dealing with the other by way of desire. Not having a parasitic, exploitative relationship with the other. That is what aloneness is. I come to you out of joy, not because I expect something out of you. That is what is aloneness. Aloneness does not mean that I will not look at anybody, and you can never be alone that way. Yes, next.
So how can I identify that where my passion lies, and how can I excel in that too?
How can I identify where my passion lies and how can I excel in that field? You really want to understand this? No, because that requires a lot of attention. How many of you are concerned with this question? Want to know where my passion lies and how to excel there? Two words then, passion and excellence. Passion and excellence. Just look at these. We have talked about desire, right? Passion is hyper desire. We said the brain is hardwired to be desirous. We said the brain is hardwired to be desirous. Similarly, the brain, this animal brain, that is a product of evolution that we share with animals as well. Similarly, this brain is hardwired to be passionate. Passion, ambition, desire, dreams, goal, purpose, all these words belong to the same family. There is no essential difference between them. Passion, dreams, ambition, goal, purpose, target, desire, there is no real difference between these words. They are all from the same family. And none of these words is a description of what you are. It's all a carryover of the evolutionary mechanism. at a particular age, you start becoming passionate about women and vice versa. You don't have much to do with it. There is this brain, and this signals for certain chemicals to be released, which you call as hormones. What have you done in all this? What have you done in all this? But then, passion for women is one of the most hardened passions mankind knows of. If the word passion is used anywhere, it is used most frequently with respect to the other gender. Passion. Be it your passion for the other gender, or be it your passion for kite flying, or gaming, or bikes, or whatever, all passion is external influence and a form of slavery. You know what is the root of the word passion? It comes from the word pain, same root, pain. You recently had this movie, The Passion of the Christ. Now, this does not mean that the Christ was passionate about being hung there. Yes, I am feeling so passionate. The word passion there referred to all the suffering that the Christ had. Are you getting it? Are you together? Or is it too much for you to take? Too much? I haven't done this one either. I'm asking you. Wait. Who asked this question? Are you getting it? The response?